I hope you're aware of that. Alright, I'm gonna steal two blocks. Trolling me without even being on the game. What the hell, Phil? I'm really glad the guy that built this map decided to include the whole stone system. Means your timing's wrong, Cookie. Timing has to be perfect, or you fail. Yeah, the first two aren't hard at all, fails. They're just kind of to get you excited and make you think it'll be easy. Alright, well, I've got a long time before nightfall sets in, and I'm not trying this motherfucker until I've slept in this bed, so I'm gonna go out for a quick cigarette. Yes, fails too much. It specifically tells you in the rules and signs at the beginning not to walk on the minecart tracks. You have to go back through any ones that you die at until you've managed to sleep in a bed. It's one of the challenges of it. Then you're dumb. Night lasts for a long time. Alright, I'm going out for a smoke break while I wait for nighttime. At the bottom of the first post on the Wizards forum. Alright, I'll be back in a bit, guys. Life.
of rides with them Indiana boys on an Indiana night.
I will eventually give it its own page, by the way, Phil, and put credits on it and whatnot, so people know that we did it. In the meantime, it's just up for whoever the fuck wants to download. Score possible, and I think it's 22 bridges. And I actually enjoy the taste of cigarettes. Damn it, I let go of up for 1 second. Yeah, I've been trying to quit for a while. This game's built, it's not cheating. It's, you're going to fail at some, so the blocks are provided for you. Sometimes, you're just gonna have to build a bridge like I have to right now, because sprinting is hard. Not as funny as Meg on our playthrough of this one, though. She made it to the very last block and then forgot to step on the stone platform.
You know that feeling. 2:30 in the afternoon.
Yeah, the trick to getting a slightly decent score is on ones like this.
Tired and groggy, but you gotta get stuff done.
You know you've gotta use blocks anyway.
So take a
5-hour energy. Just open it up,
5-hour energy is faster and easier than coffee, and man, does it work. You'll get the alert, energized feeling you need to get stuff done. A lot of stuff. 5-hour energy, when you gotta get stuff done. For more information, visit 5hourenergy.com.
Low ceiling. Give you guys a side view of this one real quick. You have a low ceiling. A little time to run through it. But if you sprint, you'll hit the front, put you in a walk, and the back will catch up. You have to time it right to where you go back and forth between sprinting and not sprinting.
Time ticks by, still I try. No rest for cross tops in my mind. On my own, here we go.
Okay, for this one, you have to set the difficulty to normal or higher. This one's called Rage Arrows. Jump timing is important for Rage Arrows. Next bridge is Wipeout. Asks you to please set it back to peaceful. Please set it back to peaceful. These challenges are all relatively easy. As long as you time it right. Oh, I'm gonna fall. Oh, I got lucky as hell. Oh, wow. Make it through the challenge and I don't sprint jump. I feel so smart. Oh, fucking hate that. Set it back to normal. You know, I was wondering for a while whether or not I did a good enough job on the arrow one to where it would kill someone if they mess up the timing and don't get the jumps right. Now, I know for a fact, my timing was great. Oh. So what do you guys think as far as, challenge-style adventure maps go? Is this one decent? Did we make it hard enough? Should we make it harder?